Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to insert an image or a photo into a shape in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm just going to go to New File. I'll click Print, Letter, and then Create. Now, the first step is to get a shape. And we have the shape tool right over here. I'm going to choose the star tool. I'm going to click, hold shift, and then drag it as big as I want. If I want a different kind of star, I can hold option or alt too. And I think I want a few more points on this, so I'll click the up arrow a couple times. I'll hold shift to make sure it's straight, and then I'll release. Okay, so this is my shape. I'm going to hit D to get a white fill and a black outline. And this doesn't really matter, but it's nice to be able to see the shape. Next, I'll place my image. So I'll go to File, Place. And here's the image that I want to put inside the star. And this image I downloaded from pexels.com. So I'll place that. Then I'm going to click and drag. I'm going to make sure I have my star completely covered. And then I'll send to back with Object, Arrange, Send to back, and I'll zoom in a little bit. Now I need to figure out where I want the picture to be inside the star. I think probably right about here. That looks good. So I'm on my selection tool. I've selected my star and I'll hold shift and select the background. And then I'll come up here and go to Object, Clipping Mask, Make. And now let's see what we've got. We no longer have the fill and stroke, the white fill and black outline on this shape. So if we want that back, we have to hit D again. The shape technically has a white fill, but we don't see it because there's a clipping mask there. So that's behind the picture we put in. And now we have a black outline. I can increase the black outline, I can round the points, but I do want to mention that if you have a high-res photo in Illustrator, like this one, it's going to make your file size quite a bit bigger, so this might be a better process in Adobe InDesign. To move both of these together, I can just get on my selection tool and then click and drag. But let's say I don't want this image right in the middle. I want to move it a little more up here. I can hit A on my keyboard to get to my direct selection tool. Click right on that image and move it around inside the shape like this. So we'll put that right here. We can also move just the shape around. To do that, I'll get my group selection tool. I'll click to find out where the lines and the anchor points are. I need to select just that part and move it around. It's a little tricky, but you'll get the hang of it pretty quick. Now, if you want to release back to just a photo and a shape, you can do that. To do that, you can go to Object, Clipping Mask, and Release. Now, let's say you have a much more complex shape. I'm going to open this raindrops file. These are vector raindrops. I'll select all of them and then I'll paste them in here. Now these are grouped, so they all move together. I put them on top of my image. I'll hold shift and select both, and then I'll hit Command 7. You can also go up to Object, Clipping Mask, and Make. But this is what I'm getting, and this is not what I want. So I'm going to undo. You might also get an error that says something like, the top shape is too complex, we can't handle it. So if that's happening, you'll want to select your vector shape pieces and make a compound path. So to do that, go to Object, Compound Path, and Make. Nothing will seem to have changed, but now when I select both by holding Shift and selecting the image and the vector shapes, and then hit Command 7, now I get what I want, which is that image showing through all the separate shapes. And you can also move it around just like I showed you before. So if you're getting an error or something that's unexpected, just undo and then make your vector objects a compound path. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.